Welcome to Thinkermetrics, demystifying the world of analytics, one graph at a time. From e-commerce metrics to app performance and the latest social media trends, we have your metrics that matter covered. The best part, you don't need to be a data pro. This is for everyone. Whether you're a UX wizard or just curious about the digital world, we make analytics fun and accessible. So grab your data about the companies you care about and fire up Excel or Tableau and join us as we make sense of the numbers together. Subscribe and join our Thinkermetrics community today. All right, microphone check 1, 2, 1, 2. My word of advice to you is just relax and just do what you got to do. If that don't work, then kick the facts. If you will find a red, a lot of flaming, not a crowd, etc. Or you want to just go, welcome to Thinkermetrics. Today, we are going to do an intro into Tableau. So what is Tableau? It is a data visualization platform. So what does that mean? That means us regular folks that are business users, UX designers maybe, or other people that just want to be able to access that data to make decisions and run their business and work in their role without a lot of complex development or understanding of those underlying structures of data like an engineer would have. And Tableau is phenomenal at that. It's got a great UI that allows you to access that data, make graphs, make new calculations, and visualize that so you can tell your data stories to ask for what you want and analyze your products, whatever that is, from a yoga studio all the way through to e-commerce, apps, and all of the amazing social media platforms. So there is so much we can do with it. And why do it in Tableau? You can also do it in Excel and Power BI and things like that. So we'll cover Tableau today, but those are other options. And why there and not within the social media platform tool? So like, for example, YouTube has their own analytics platform. Meta with Facebook and Instagram has their own, but they have their own interfaces and it just has the data in those platforms. And usually when you're doing something like an advertising campaign or looking at your brand or business as a whole, you want to look at all of the data as a whole and stitch that together. So what does your content calendar look like for social media paired with your e-commerce data from purchases, paired with what was happening on the website with visits and the checkout flow? So all those things you want to bring together in one place so you can tell a complete data story. So today we're just going to navigate around Tableau and get used to what it looks like with some real data in it. So we're going to use some data from RelatedLinks, which is a social media cross-platform service where you're able to put in competitors and your own data and look at how they're doing across TikTok, YouTube, Facebook, and more, and be able to see that cross-platform view. So they also have a trial. We cover it in another video linked in this description below. But today, we're just going to look at it a little bit more casually so we can get a feel for the Tableau user interface here. So here is a blank workbook, and what we want to do is connect to that data that I downloaded in a CSV file before. So we are going to, you could go to connect to data, and you'll see this pop-up screen. There are two options. So usually we will be using Excel or a CSV file. There are other options as well, like JSON and some others, bringing in from a PDF, for example. Or in a work environment, you'll probably be bringing it in from something like a SQL Server database or something else. So I'm gonna go to more, and I'm going to bring in this data for Halo Top. So Halo Top Ice Cream, no relation to the Beyonce song, is right here. And this is that data source tab in the lower left you'll see in Tableau. And you can see the data that it attempted to bring in here below. So Tableau does its best job trying to figure out what type of data it has, numbers and text strings, and you'll see that here, and you can change it if it gets it wrong. So we're gonna hop over in a second to the sheets, the worksheets, where we can make graphs, and we can change some of these right there in that part of the page, but no, you can also change it here before you hop right in there. So we're gonna go to sheet one, and on the left, you have two sections. If you scroll, there's a lot of data on this one particular file since there's so many social platforms, and there's a dividing line there. So the ones above that are supposed to be dimensions. So dimensions are things like the date, categories, your name, things that you're going to be graphing measures, the numbers across. So how many likes per day did you get, or how many total likes? So those are measures and these are dimensions. As you can see, Tableau in this case did not get these right. So Tableau might want to ramp up the AI on figuring out what is a measure and a dimension on here. Usually it's pretty good. I don't know why, something about this file kind of confuses it a little bit. There is another Tableau product called Tableau Prep that does a lot better at these sorts of things, but we're just going to use it in here because it's kind of easy and there's just a few things we need to change to do that. So we have a date here, and these are strings, so the name of the company, and then these different measures. So like I said, these are probably wrong. So these are actually measures. So you can right click one at a time, or you can click multiple with shift on your keyboard. And I'm going to click on those and right click and convert to measure. So now those are down there in measures, and we'll be able to graph with them. It might mess up the graphs a little bit if we do it from up here, depending on what we're trying to build. And then I also noticed that was a string. So I'm going to practice right clicking on that and changing that data type into a number. And this is an engagement rate. So I know that as like a decimal, since it's going to be like, 2.33 engagements per day or something like that. If it was a whole number, like downloads or something like that, you would want a whole number. So normally when we graph something, we want to ask a question. So what am I trying to figure out by graphing it? It's not just to have fun, although today that kind of is the purpose, but what do I want to know about these companies? So how well are they doing in regards to TikTok? So maybe what we're going to do is make sure we get our TikTok metrics down there. It looks like average views per day, engagement total per day, and posts. There's probably some on the bottom as well, but we're going to go ahead and convert those to measure, make sure they're down here, see what the rest of the ones they have here. I'm looking particularly to TikTok views. So let's see if these companies are even posting on TikTok and see what happens. So I'm going to put the date there and I'm going to right click on the date. It put year. I know this is just 2 months of data for them, for example. So I'm going to click exact date. And now I want to do TikTok views. So I can actually type up here and it'll just filter it down to those. I could have scrolled all the way, but that's a little bit easier. So now I'm going to put TikTok views. So this is the total views of all those four companies. And what I want to know is by company what that looks like. So I can take that company name and I can drag it and drop it onto the marks tab here in the center. And we can see the company's results. So these are the views by company. And so I'm going to take the tab there where it says sheet one and say TikTok views by company. I guess company's kind of obvious, so we'll leave it for there. So you have TikTok views. It already says that on the axis. So a little shout out to minimalism because I'm going to double click on that and I don't need that if it's in the title. So if you don't have it in the title, then you need it. But if you do, you're good. So you can also double click on this. I actually like editing in the tab first, the name. So making it clear as we make multiple tabs what it is. And then up here, you can keep that sheet name and then Tableau will pull in whatever you have in that tab. So if I go down here and click this, say something else like by company, then that'll change up there. And you can do for this, you could say 2023. Think it's in January and February, but we can look at the data and see. But just for an example of how you would create a title where you have an automatically changing top to it, and that you can of course change formatting as much as you would like, could change the font to get it out of the Tableau default to whatever you would like. Probably not that. So make it something readable. And there you go. So we also have the color there as well. You can try clicking the color in the marks tab and you can click edit colors. This is the automatic default color palette. I'm definitely tired of it. You can choose whatever you would like there. You can look at what Seattle looks like for 8 months a year up here and the super gray area, or make it a little brighter with maybe summer palette there. And you can change individually. So you can pull from that palette and change those if they're too close together, like those were. That's a little bit better. And now you can assign that palette, we'll pull it over like that, or you change them individually like that and then apply. And so now they're applied on our graph. So all sorts of things you can do on this graph that are fun. You can change the marks tab here to things like a bar graph. You can change it to shapes. So you could make those stars, for example. So those have TikTok views. So maybe we do something a little bit different. So that's the views, but for example, 1,000 of my posts maybe get 1,000 likes. So that's actually not super efficient. If you're a brand looking to hire an influencer, probably wouldn't hire me. You want to hire someone that gets 1 million likes per post, like a Kardashian or Emma Chamberlain or Mr. Beast or whatever. And so this is the number of views, and we also have the number of posts. So let's figure out what posts. So we have posts there, and you could put it on the same screen. So you have two different metrics there. So that's the number of posts. And you could even right-click on the second one and make a dual axis graph so it overlays it. But that's a little confusing because they are different shapes. So you could do something like a line graph for the views, and then the number of posts is the star. So there's different ways where you can figure out what presentation makes the most sense for you. And then you can even, instead of doing the number of views on the screen like that, let's pull it off. And then we can make that the size of the star. So we can exaggerate the size of the star too. So the star is now the number of views, and the posts are there. So they've been, for example, Enlightened posted three on those dates, but they only got 300 and 600 views. Whereas Ginny's, we're rocking it there with some sort of Brambleberry crisp ice cream, has got thousands. So nice work, whoever's on the social team at Ginny's. So one thing we can do too is go to the Show Me tab up here and has other options for graphs. So sometimes it'll say below there, you need one more measure or one more dimension because different graphs require different things. Like having a line series, you're going to need a date so you can see a time series graph across time. You can also switch to bar charts so you can see what we have on a bar chart. So of all of those, we've got posts and views. Let's make it views for the slice of the pie as well. So it looks like three quarters of the total views on TikTok for these four companies are Jenny's. So the other two don't post at all. But so, you know, that's kind of how it goes. You can also make this tiny bar chart bigger right there with the entire view. Or the other way to do it is Command Shift B or Control Shift B, and you can make that a little bit bigger. This pie chart or So Command Shift B will get that bigger. One thing there is I probably don't need the dates because it's only those 2 months, all in 2023. We are missing something though. I have definitely received graphs in my life with no labels at all, and that doesn't tell me a whole lot. So we can click Control on our keyboard and drag and drop views onto the label. We can also even do the same thing. So Control, drag and drop the company name there. So I always like having the data close to the graph to what you're looking at, so it prevents a lot of eye movement back and forth, and the viewer understands what you want them to as soon as possible. And so now that that's there, I actually don't even need the legends because it's already on there. And what we can do here is click that label area. Since I drag and drop them on that, you can go to text, you can highlight that, you can change the format to be different. So now you can see the company name and the views in a different way. And I'll show you another hack that's pretty neat. If you click the font, click match mark color, it matches exactly there. So nothing for those two, but you can see immediately when you look at it that Ginny's has 13,972 views on TikTok and Enlightened only has 4,554. A couple more quick tips on making graphs in Tableau. We're going to bring in our company name already. You can see it right here. And a note, you can also change the size of many of these things with the arrow bar there. And so you can also hide that title above there. So I know those are company names. There's no need for me to explain that those are company names. So you can hide field label for those columns. And what I want to do here is work on Instagram data. So we're going to change that as we go. We want to figure out how they are doing on Instagram. So we're going to refine that question as we figure out what we have. And so remember, we can type up here to see what measures for Instagram that we have for these companies. And we can bring in what I want to see is how many times they're posting. So how many times are these company's posting on Instagram. Right there, you can see Tableau chose the aggregation sum. We'll use other ones like average later. That was the default that it had. And notice it brought in the data in the order that it had in the data. We can do something different though. Up here, you can sort descending from largest to smallest, or ascending from smallest to largest there. So that makes it a lot easier for the viewer to process, especially if some that are close in size across that data and further away from each other. It would be maybe hard with your eye to visually figure that out. You know, like those optical illusions, everyone fails that in that study that they do in psychology class. We also have transpose here, was what they call it in Excel, but in Tableau, they call it swap rows and columns. You can do that with the shortcut key Control W, as it says there on the screen. That makes it look like that. And moving me out of the way, you can see we can expand and make that bigger as well. So that is the number of posts. So now we know how many posts they're making, but how well are they doing? So I'm a big fan of ratios or rates. So how do you tell you're being able to do well? It's how much engagement you're getting per post. I mean, really, the impact matters overall, but being able to figure out how well you're doing on those posts so you can tell your team to start, stop, or continue doing something is really what we're going out with here. But you can also measure the total impact. Just depends on the question you're trying to answer. So one thing we haven't done is to take that engagement rate, and I'm going to drag and drop it onto color. So now the intensity of the color is based on that. So maybe we don't have any data in there and we want to find something else. Engagement rate per post. Let's drop that one on there. Looks like that is the right one I was looking for. So now we can tell that even though the number of posts in total are higher for Enlightened Ice Cream, Jenny's is performing much better there. And so the ability to add this as a layer of color as an overlay makes it so that when your viewer sees this, they know very quickly how the companies are performing. So maybe for the question, we put posts quantity versus engagement rate per post. So it's a little dry. You could change it to a question or something like that, but that is one way to do it, and it does make a good graph. And like I said before, we can change the color here, and you can change that. In this case, instead of a palette, you're changing a gradient here, and you can choose something. A lot of times you'll go red for negative, black for positive, like in finance, or maybe you've got something else that's a little more exciting, like the sunset one. There might be a little bit confusing on which one is the largest or smallest. So maybe we choose something a little bit more simple. Maybe go for green and gold. And you can see that green is good in this case. So there you go. We've got a few more tips there in Tableau. So a lot of fun. We can work with these graphs. We can also drag and drop things onto a tooltip. So a tooltip is another word for a hover. So any metric we put on there, you can drag and drop, and you will see in this screen. So this screen looks a little bit robotic and everything. You don't have to make it like that. You can make it look however you want in whatever format. So you can say company name. You can even write it like a sentence. Had an engagement rate of, and then keep that code sort of looking carrots around it. And that Instagram likes from that many posts. So now it almost sounds human-like, and you can click OK. You could even, if you wanted to, in that tooltip, change colors and all sorts of stuff like that. So now, if you hover over those, you can see the sentence of that comparison between the engagement rate and the number of posts. The digital day.